Hey guys, in our last video, we learned how we can create our first application in Blazor. And in this video, I'm going to talk about how we can add a page into our Blazor app. So these are the pages which come out of the box. And let's explore these pages so that we can add our page along with these pages. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to open this pages folder. And if you look at this index file, which shows Hello World, same as the first startup page here. And one thing to notice here is at the top, it shows at the page forward slash. That means this page doesn't really have an address. So when you start the application, this is the first page which gets loaded. Sweet. Let's look at this counter page, counter.razor file, which is same as this counter page here. And if you look at top, now you can see at the page forward slash counter, that means this page has an address. So if you want to go to this page, you'll have to type forward slash counter in order to get to the page. Sweet. So what's there in this file? You can see there's HTML here and there's some code here. So in HTML, I'm showing the current count and there is a button where I'm calling increment count function. And there is code where it's initializing the current count and there's a function which is getting called on the button. So you can have HTML and code on the same file. And if you're wondering that is it possible to keep code and HTML separate, you can totally do that. We're going to learn that in our future videos. One thing to notice here that is if I change the text here and save the page and come back here and reload the page, you can see that you can't really see the changes on the browser. These razor pages don't really work like HTML. And I googled about it and there are some NuGet packages that you can install, but it doesn't really work. I hope they have runtime compilation enabled in their future releases so that when we make changes in the razor files, we'll be able to see the changes on the browser. Sweet. Let's look at this fetch data file now. In fetch data, when I open this page here on the browser, you can see that this page is about weather forecasts and it's showing the weather forecast for the next 5 days. So today is 10:10 at this time and it's showing the weather forecasts in Celsius and in Fahrenheit and for the next 5 days. So how is it pulling this information? Let's look at the page. When I look at the page, I see some HTML here and I see a table which is looping through this forecast variable and showing the forecast for the next 5 days. So where is this forecast variable getting initialized? It gets initialized in the code and this class is defined here in this data folder. Now open this data folder, you can see that weather forecast class is defined here. And it has date, temperature in Celsius, Fahrenheit, and summary. And to load this array, what's happening here is on initializing the page, we're calling an async function, getForecastAsync. And then we're getting that information from this date and loading into array. Cool. But where's the service coming from? This service is defined here. And in this service, you can see the function is defined here, getForecastAsync. And we're just getting random temperature for the next 5 days. That's what's written here. But to use this service, what you can see on top of the page, that we are using dependency injection to create the variable. And then we can consume the service. That's pretty cool about Blazor, and I'm super excited to explore that. You can do dependency injections in Blazor. Cool. So let's add our page into that's how weather forecast works. Let's add our page into it. So to add our page, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to right click on the pages and create a new Razor component, and I'm going to call it authors, because I want to show authors on my page. So when I create the page, It shows authors as heading by default, and we will need an address so that browser knows where to go and look for this file. So what I'm gonna do here, just like fetch data and counter, we need an address for authors. So I'm gonna say authors here. And so, but we need to add this page into our menu, our navigation menu. Let's open this folder shared. When I open this folder shared, you can see there's a main layout, which is the main layout of the page of the application, where on the left-hand side, on the sidebar, you can see there's a navigation menu getting rendered. And that's pretty cool about Blazor. It's like you can create Razor components and reuse those Razor components in your application, in your project. And you can see on the left-hand side, there's body. But what I'm curious about is this nav menu. And this nav menu you can find here. This nav menu gets rendered when on the left-hand side of our main layout. When I open this nav menu, you can see that our navigation items, our navigation links are mentioned here. There is home, counter, fetch data, and us going to a proper address in order to get to that page. So what I'm gonna do here is copy this and add another menu item. I'm gonna call it authors. I'm gonna mention the link for this nav link as authors and name my items as authors. Cool, let's run this and see what happens. So when I run it, you can see we have added authors. This page getting populated here now after fetch data. And when I click on it, you can see it's showing authors, and in the address, you can see authors as the address /. So if you wanna go to the page, you can see authors here. Sweet. So that's how you can add a page into your Blazor app. In my next video, I'm gonna talk about routing. I'm gonna show how you can pass parameters into your page. And if you wanna go to a particular address, how you can do that. And if you have any questions about how you can add a page into your Blazor app or how the project is set up, put it in the comment section. I'll try to get back to you. This is Fahad. See you soon. Bye.